Why I adore Miles, because he would not tap dance for anybody like Sammy Davis Jr. With all respect to Sammy Davis Jr. and Michael Jackson, they're more like entertainers. Miles Davis was not an entertainer. He was a seriously brutal artist, musician, that would not comply with the plastic system.
Can't help it, you know. It's not that I'm a genius, but it's just that I can't help it. I play it one way so long, I just have to change my way, you know, in order to give it to you so you'll like it.
So he got rid of the Italian suits and he started wearing different kind of clothing. And that it all went together, it all happened at the same time. Psychologically, I think the people who put it to him that he needed to change if he was tired of playing clubs, four concerts a night for very little money and very little audience, you know, I think it was like Clive Davis, Mr. Clive Davis, Mr. Bill Graham, and of course, Betty Davis.
This young, beautiful black woman that with this fire and spirit and freshness that kind of opened Miles' eyes up.
He was a big freak!
Betty Davis was the first Madonna, but Madonna is like more like Donny Osmond compared to Betty Davis. You know, Betty Davis is a real ferocious Black Panther woman, and I can see why Miles was very attracted to her. She was indomitable. You know, you couldn't tame Betty Davis. You know, musically, philosophically, and physically, she was extreme and attractive. You know, so I could see why Miles changed so drastically. Next time we saw him, you know, he was, everything changed. It all happened within a period of maybe 3 to 6 months. The music just changed. And I'm happy that it did. I welcome it. I feel that we all benefit a lot from his courage to embrace the future full on.
Introduced Miles to Jimi Hendrix music and kind of opened that avenue up for Miles. Got him interested in rock and roll, but the hardcore rock stuff.
yes, he learned a lot from James Brown, Sly Stone, and Jimi Hendrix, and maybe Santana to a certain extent. But he would always take all this music and take it to a level that we would have to listen to him. You know, he's the one that turned around Jimi Hendrix by playing Jack Johnson, where Jimi Hendrix was like.
My great thrill is stepping into the ring, feeling rosin under my feet, waiting for the sound of the bell. Some fighters say they're nervous in the ring. Others feel fear. But me, I feel happy. I'm Jack Johnson, heavyweight champion of the world. I'm black. They never let me forget it. I'm black, all right. I'll never let them forget it.
I have a trainer. Yeah, he trains
whenever
he has time.
Do you go to the boxing bouts very often?
Well, I go when I can. And I usually go up to the gym about 3 times a week.
Oh, and work out yourself?
And mess around.
Oh, yeah? Have to be careful with your lips there, you know.
Well, I don't get in the lip.
There's really something, connection between the boxing and his way of playing. When he'd start throwing and, you know, put your hand and block and feint and, you know, jab and everything. It's the speed, the in and out, the reaction time, the feinting, the move, the combinations, because boxing is a real art. I mean, this is like a thing that I think Miles really was able to see. And it went along, right along with his thing, timing and nuance. Jazz, the main ingredient, is the improvisational aspect. For me, that's the beauty of it. We're trained to be fast. Fast technically, fast thinking, fast hearing, fast reactions, ability to perceive what is coming, what seems to be coming.
Miles' music, the last note is where everything's at. It's like jab, 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 and then the main punch.
Somebody told me you always think like a fighter.
If you see a good boxer, it's a form of art, you know, like Sugar Ray Lux, jab, you know, three hooks, that combination, he knew what was coming. He would hook it right in. Bam, bam!
That music is very, very soothing. It's like when you hear the first birds in the morning, the sound of the first birds in the morning is very relaxing. And you got to remember that at that time it was the peak of brutality in America, the shootings of Martin Luther King and the Kennedys and Malcolm X and the war in Vietnam and the shooting, the riots in the street with the hippies and, you know, so this music was very soothing, very healing, you know, and then Miles got caught up with the, you know, the craziness, and the music started becoming more like